One of the most amazing features of FNC Maps are its capabilities when it comes to directions. Turn-by-turn instructions can be accessed using object instances, and you can visualize them in your user interfaces. You can use them to do very specific calculations based on directions. The flexibility is limitless. Now TMS introduces specific directions for trucks with here mapping. The use case is that you can plan your routes now for cargo transports using trucks. It is offered through the here mapping service, and you can specify the parameters of the vehicle and the cargo that is being used. Looking at the parameters in detail, you see that it is a simple object that you have to customize when you look up the directions. You can specify the weight of the cargo, you can specify the height and the width of the vehicle, and the speed cap it has to abide to. Also, tunnels can be categorized so that you can restrict the route not to use certain tunnels. Also, you can say that you want to avoid difficult turns and that your cargo contains hazardous materials. In practice, it looks like this. You can specify if you want a fast route, a short route, and you can add all these specific restrictions. You don't have to, you can. For example, if I don't specify any of the restrictions, I'm getting a normal route designed for trucks. In this case, I'm driving from Atlanta to Los Angeles. I asked my buddy Willis, who is a truck driver here in the area, what is a very common route he takes. And he said, like, Atlanta to Los Angeles is very common. And you can't take the direct approach because there are actually restrictions. So for example, if I enable the weight, width, and height restriction, and then I have to avoid difficult turns, right now the duration is approximately 36 hours. If I calculate the same route again, then my time actually increases to 71 hours and I have to take a completely different route because the roads that I've used before cannot abide by these restrictions. There were difficult turns, there were height and width restrictions, and probably there were bridges. Because I specified a total weight of 40 metric tons, which is a lot. So this shows you how flexible this is. You can now specify all these criteria which are used in logistic businesses to make sure that your cargo can be delivered on a truck using the route. And of course, as always, TMS provides the programming interface using objects and records so that you can instantly access all the different points on this route. Still, let's look at the source code of this example, how easy it is if you just want to paint the route and get the characteristics like the total duration. First, let me point out that this is a FireMonkey application and not just a Windows VCL application. That means this works cross-platform on all the platforms that FireMonkey supports. As you saw in my demonstration, if you click the route button, all these characteristics here are being transferred somewhere and then the route is being calculated. First, one of the biggest features of FNC Maps is that we use a Google map, which is here using the FNC Maps component with a service property set to Google Maps, but still I can use the routing capability of a completely different mapping service. I still draw the result on my Google map, however, the results are being calculated by a different provider. Because right now, Google does not have any truck-specific directions. The here service does. So what I do is I drop a FNC here directions component on the form and use that component to get the routing information. And then I can apply this information on my Google map and paint it if I want to. Let's look how I get that information. First, I need the latitude, longitude for origin and destination. This is hard-coded here. These are the coordinates of Atlanta and Los Angeles. And then I have to transfer everything from the user interface into some record or object. On the slide, I already showed you what that object is. If we look at the here directions component, that is the name that I picked for it, you find the options property, and that options property has a truck specific property. And there we can set exactly what I showed you on the slide: the weight, height, width, speed cap, tunnel category, if I want to avoid difficult turns, hazardous materials, and that's it. And this is what I do. I transfer, if checked, the different properties. We use zero if we don't want to specify a restriction. Otherwise, we set a value. This is true for all of the integer properties. There is no designed Boolean value that you have to enable or disable. If you don't want to restrict, you use zero. Otherwise, any other value is being interpreted as a restriction. The only exception, of course, are the Boolean properties like avoid tunnels, avoid dirt roads, and avoid difficult turns. Same for hazardous materials. After setting up the parameters, I add two markers on the map, one for the origin coordinate, the other one for the destination. And then it's this very simple call: get directions from origin to destination. These here, if we invoke code completion, we see that these are actually callbacks if we wanted to specify them, an ID if we have multiple direction requests going on in the background, not needed, so we can specify an empty string, just like we don't need the callback because we are going to use the event of the here directions component. You'll see that in a second. And this one here is a data pointer if you want to transfer specific information to this request so you can access it, for example, in the event. We don't want to use that either. And then, do we want to calculate multiple alternatives? In this case, no, false. And here's the key thing: you have to specify the travel mode as TM truck. There's other travel modes like vehicle, bike, but in this case, we have to specify truck. And that will trigger the specific route calculation that will also access the truck specific options that we specified. And with that, you might think, well, where do I get the results? Well, remember, every call is an asynchronous call. That means if we go to the directions component right here and go to the events, there's the onGetDirections event. That is the event that is being triggered as soon as we get a reply. This reply can be successful or not. That's why we have to check a request result success. If it is true, the request was successful, but a successful request does not mean that we actually got a route. For example, a request can be successful, but the returned answer can still be, I couldn't find any routes that conform to the requirements that you have. That's still a possible answer. In this case, we also check that we have at least one route returned. Routes are being collected in the items property of the TTMS FNC directions request type. With that, we can start. We can say the duration is, let me invoke code completion for you on this very specific type, items 0. And there we see we have these things like different legs, coordinates, distance, duration. I could also output the distance, very, very simple, by reading distance. Summary is a string that summarizes everything. And then here I can access all the different waypoints, steps, and so on. In this case, I'm just going to approximate the duration in hours, dividing the seconds by 3,600. This, of course, the minutes and everything is being forgotten. I'm just interested in the hours here. And then drawing the route is very, very simple. I simply specify the coordinates from the route, convert them to an array, and pass them to at polyline. And this polyline I can then customize using stroke opacity, stroke width, and stroke color. And finally, just like we've seen in so many cases, I zoom to the bounds so that I actually see the whole route on my map by using zoom to bounds with the coordinate array of the route that has been found. And believe it or not, that's it. If you wanted to use different properties of the route, you would do that here. You would get all the different waypoints with a distance, with a turn-by-turn instructions. This would be the place to read those and have a look at those. So not only is it very, very simple to create truck-specific routes with these parameters, this is also supported for the VCL, FireMonkey, and TMS WebCore in your web applications. That means FNC Maps is your solution for Windows, macOS, Linux, and even the Raspberry Pi. If you want to learn more, go to the landing page fnc.tmssoftware.com, click FNC Maps, and then get a trial version. Try it out if you're not already a customer, and find out how easy it is to build truck-specific routing instructions with FNC Maps.